People who orders products online as a prank may be liable for estafa and face possible imprisonment. According to DTI Undersecretary Ruth Castelo, this is under the revised penal code that is punishable. Prank orders are those who order online, such as food, but eventually no-show or made it cancel. The official said that the Philippine National Police and the National Bureau of Investigation are ready to accept complaints. Sellers and delivery personnel should keep text messages or other proof of the prank so that the DTI could help them file a complaint.
Magkukulong yan. Kailangan lang tulungan din tayo ng complainant kung siya yung seller or yung food delivery platform na madala, makapag-complain siya, mag-execute ng affidavit at makapag-complain, tutulungan natin sila sa PNP or sa NBI.
Carl, a delivery service personnel, experienced getting pranked buyers. He said that even if the ride-hailing delivery company reimbursed the amount that they spent on the unpaid item, it still affects their livelihood.
Pakiusap lang namin sa mga customer, huwag naman po sana kaming iprank kasi numumuhunan din ho kami, tsaka napapagod din kami, nag-aantay kami rito sa merchant, tapos ihahatid pa namin, tapos di rin magpapakita, di ba ang hirap?
DTI has recorded around 15,000 online transaction complaint this year compared with around 2,500 last year. The lower chamber passed the House Bill 7805 or the Internet Transaction Act that will protect customers and online merchants. If the bill be enacted, online customers who found violated provisions may be fined of up to 50,000 pesos while up to 500,000 for online merchants and ride-hailing service providers. Ray Pelayo, UNTV News and Rescue. We serve the people, we give glory to God.